Do self-help books have you singing the minimalism blues? Hi, I'm Kate and I'm here to help you re-clutter. Getting organized doesn't mean you have to throw away your worldly goods, toss aside precious keepsakes, or part with your kids' childhood scribbles. In this series, I will show you how I build and store collections, sort and organize my possessions, sneakily hide practical but ugly items out of sight, and display my clutter in a way that makes me happy. This world has so many amazing knickknacks, collectibles, works of art, books, memorabilia, clothes, tools, gadgets, animal-shaped table lamps, mannequin parts, novelty handbags. It's a shame that the current aspirational living space contains practically none of that. So come join me in making our spaces percolate with personality in a very organized way. In today's episode of Re-clutter, I'll be showing you 5 ways that I like to hide things out of sight. These are things that you might not necessarily use every single day, things that aren't that pretty to look at, so you don't really want them on display. But most of them are ways that are still easily accessible and ways that don't uglify your space. They help you to, you know, keep things out of view without getting rid of those things. You don't have to get rid of any of your pretty things to make room for your useful things. It's for me, it's about finding ways to find storage in the space that you already have, because you obviously can't increase the amount of space you have, but you can find ways to utilize it in a way that works better for you. Now, I should add before I start any of this that it's pretty clear from my space that clutter might mean something different to me than it does to you. Visual clutter can be things, it can also be colors. I have a lot of patterns, prints, and different colors in my living space. If you considered what my space would look like if everything was one single color, like if I had a white bedspread and I had a white bed and I had white pillowcases, and then I had like just a plain wooden bed frame, and I did not decide to hang posters up all over my wall, I would actually have a very clean, organized space. It has visual clutter because I like that, but you can use these tips to, you know, like adjust them based on how much clutter you like having. So if you're somebody who does need to hide things out of sight and you need to find more ways to store things, this is a great, a great episode for you. You don't have to look at this and be like, well, she likes having stuff everywhere, therefore this isn't for me. You can just adjust the tips based on how much clutter you like having. But just keep in mind that there are ways to make your space organized without throwing out your stuff. You just find room for your stuff. So let's get started. My first tip for hiding things out of the way is if you have curtains that are pulled back and go all the way to the floor, you can hide things back there. I keep my clothes steamer hidden behind the pulled up fabric. So you would never know it's there, but there it is. One more way that I like to hide things out of sight, this also involves curtains. If you have a curtain panel that's on the side of your window and you never pull it all the way back, you can hide things hanging on the curtain rod. I use garden hooks and I just hang it from the curtain rod. And then here I bought a little, it's like a kid's shoe organizer, and I use it to store all of my sunglasses. But then when I pull the curtain, you'd never know that anything is there. If you have any extra handbags, rather than putting them away, use them for extra storage. I hang some of mine up like this. And inside I have all of my extra makeup items that I don't use on a daily basis. And then this little has all of my self-tanning materials, like mitts and stuff in it. I have this bag over here is hanging in my closet. That's filled with things. Every single bag that I'm not currently using to tote around stuff when I leave the house is filled with other stuff. And then if you want to switch bags, you just move everything into another bag. but it's cute storage, and you would never know that I have a bunch of clutter in here. But I didn't have to get rid of any of my stuff. Next time that I need, you know, just say a bright red lipstick that I don't wear every day, I'll go in this bag and get it rather than having to go to Target and buy a brand new red lipstick. Another tip is don't just consider under the bed storage, consider under the dresser storage. If you buy a 12 by 12 inch scrapbook case or a gift box, those fit perfectly under dressers. So this is a 12 by 12 inch plastic container that I'm using to store button materials, and it slides perfectly under my dresser. So it's like an under the bed box for your dresser. A great tip for fitting more storage into your room is to buy furniture that doubles as storage. Or just keep in mind how you could utilize a piece of furniture for storage if that comes up. So for instance, I needed a new workbench for my computer, and I previously had one that was just sort of like a kitchen chair kind of style, but then I decided to get a storage bench instead. It takes up exactly the same amount of room that my other one did, but it comes with this bonus. I have all of our family photos stored in here, and I've slowly been taking out a little at a time to scan them at my computer. So this is packed. Look how far it goes. It goes really far down. And all of this used to be out. So now I saved all of that room, and it's not necessarily the prettiest things to have out and about. So they're all stored now under my bench. And I also covered it with with a little blanket because I didn't like the plain white. And even if you're not buying furniture that's specifically for storage, you can keep in mind when you're buying a piece of furniture how you can utilize it. So for instance, when I bought this bed, I wanted one that would have a lot of space between the floor and where the mattress sits. My mattress actually sits pretty high on here, so this whole space from here all the way down can be utilized for storage. I have an IKEA bookcase underneath, so I have books stored here. And then on top of the bookcase, I have additional storage under my bed. And then on the other side of my bed, I've put in like big plastic containers to keep under the bed. And I also keep my suitcases under the bed in between trips. So again, you definitely need a bed in your bedroom. Why not get one that has all of that square footage utilized for storage? Thank you for watching this episode of Re-clutter. If you liked it, I hope you'll consider giving it a thumbs up and possibly subscribing. I'm planning on having a new episode of Re-clutter out once a month, but I'll still be posting my regular videos every single week. So check back next week, and I'll see you then. Bye!